my microwave auditory effect, or V2K, started in the summer of 2010.
Okay, V2K, voice to skull.
Voice to skull.
Voice to skull, also known as V2K, is a form of harassment in which the victim claims that voices are being beamed directly into their minds through modulated waves that can silently travel great distances and temporarily incapacitate victims.
The idea is that V2K can be used as what they call an invisible scarecrow to get in people's heads, to drive them virtually insane.
How would you describe the audio?
It was like a cell phone up to my ear. It was so crystal clear. It was nonstop. I was getting sleep deprivation. They'd keep me up for, I think the longest I was up for was 8 days. They told me that you might want to consider suicide.
To me, the ones that are credible are those who are searching for answers. They're saying, why is this happening to me? Who is responsible? How are they doing it? All I want to know is, how can I make it stop?
Richard meets up with surveillance expert Rob, and the two of them travel to Ron's house to review the evidence that he's collected.
So welcome. This is home, Ron.
Welcome to my house.
When you arrive at Ron Gilman's house, you are in for quite a sight. From the TV out front that plays 24/7 to the telescopes pointing up into the sky.
What's going on here?
This is the most I believe I can do legally to introduce to the world of what's going on and what's about to happen to everybody.
Shall we head in?
Yes, let's. Yeah.
Is there any history of mental illness in your family?
There's absolutely no mental illness in my family. Never, ever a question about my mental ability, ever.
But who's to say that any mental health issues may not have been caused by being subjected to electronic torture 24 hours a day for 7 days a week?
Oh, exactly. I'm stressed. You know, I'm worn out. Sleep deprivation takes its toll. It's amazing what has come about in my life in the last month in this house.
How do you mean?
The technology that I have seen. I've seen holograms. I have video of all this.
And you made copies?
You know, I did. They're on one of those SD cards.
We'll look at those. During my conversation with Ron, I thought he could definitely be a targeted individual. Then Ron started talking about seeing holographic images. It just started to raise a few flags.
There's no way they did that. They just told me. I've had these on me ever since I got them, so there's no way they
just. What happened?
They just told me that they got them.
The voices told you what?
They just told me that they got those tapes. There's no way. Well, there is a way. I mean, I got to sleep, so. Let's see what
you mean these have been bulk erased, or?
Oh, man. I've had so much erased, it's not even funny. But, you know, let's see.
Yeah, oh, hey, what is this? Underground parking garage? Or no, this is your house.
This is car right
That's
there.
Your car,
it's
okay.
Apartments. There we go.
Oh, wow, is that it? Oh, okay, there's a hologram right in here. This is another one. Here he is, see him? See the, well, wait, no, hold on, don't let me get excited. Where's that light coming from? Okay, there were two people. God, let me go with that. Oh, it's gonna be cut on and off.
Oh, this is security camera footage.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay,
we'll these guys came in the house. There's one standing here the other night.
Well, we're back in the kitchen here. Is this what we're looking at here?
Okay, this is one that happened the other night. God, I'm glad I have that one at least. Okay, what you're gonna see is, again.
Okay, here we are.
Okay, let's see where I can find him here. They're a little bit more obvious than that. You know, maybe if I fast forward, I probably just went right to.
But these images were moving, right?
Oh, yeah, they move.
Okay, they're stationary. There's nothing.
Yeah,
there.
There's projection in here. I mean, they're projected in here. They're not here.
But no, but they are moving around. Okay, yeah. I didn't see anything there. But,
well, yeah, I mean, it's very hard to, every time I show a tape, you know, everyone wants to see that thing right away, and it's very, even for me to see him is difficult sometimes, but it looks to me like he's, God dang it, I wish I had a pause. Okay, you see right here?
Yes.
You see that thing?
Okay, I see two sort of little...
glasses!
Like, yeah, okay, yeah, perhaps.
Okay, there's a man and a woman here at that time.
Can you show me what you've done in terms of countermeasures and how you're trying to shield yourself or protect yourself?
Sure. Ron's kind of an inventor. Do anything to get rid of the frequency. Oh, I had a big, big blast to the head, yeah. Bad boy blast. I mean, it's a major hit. You know, just a bam. I'm proud of this thing. It took me a while to build it.
So this is made out of paper mache. And what do you have? What are these?
These are speakers. Yep.
And then it's hooked up to AM, FM, or?
Actually, I had it hooked up to CD. I don't like AM, FM. Because I believe they're transmitted over that. Am I wrong?
It would be one of the easiest ways for us to do it if we wanted to transmit something is through AM, FM.
So when the V2K would get really bad, you would put on this helmet.
And that's what I gotta do.
Do you have eye holes through there? You can watch TV or?
Yeah, I have eyeballs in here. I just don't know which way I'm going right now.
Rob, try it on because you're the height.
That's not gonna happen. No, no. If it was connected, I would.
No? Because I'm claustrophobic. I want to get a sense of what you experience when you put this thing on.
You know, this is what it took, paper mache.
Yeah, no, this is not pleasant for me. Ron Gilman is, I say, a little eccentric. He's taken extraordinary measures and a very proactive approach to try and shield him from some of these effects from directed energy weapons. He's constructed this rather silly-looking papier-mâché helmet with 16 speakers all attached to an AM-FM radio to block out these voices in his head. Now, to an outsider, it might look rather ridiculous, but for Ron, it seems to give him some relief, and who am I to argue? This is your Mylar vest.
This is what I call my, you know, safety vest.
It's like a little codpiece.
I don't care how I look. I'm not going to be attacked by, because I know they can heat up my body.
Right.